everybody. I just got done doing a pour on a vase. You can see right there, I did a video on that. And I've got a ton of paint left over. As you can see, all that paint in the bottom, there was a lot. So I just put it in this cup. And we're gonna see what happens. So what I'm gonna do, and there's no, actually I'm gonna put some alcohol in there. One little squirt. And just take my stick and go, because it's already kind of mixed there. So what I have another cup with some crazy colors in it. There's some yellow, there's these colors right here, which are Fine Touch Green, Fine Touch Phthalo Blue, there's Folk Art Brushed Gray, is that what it is? Brushed Dark Gray. Also, the blue and the gray have the Artist Loft medium, iridescent medium in them. I think in this cup I also have the Artist Loft metallic yellow. There's silver. Somewhere's my silver. There's silver in there. I think there's metallic blue, metallic turquoise. I'm not sure. There's a kind of a hodgepodge in there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to dump this cup, and that's what I got from the bottom. Just going to do a flip cup and leave it there for a second. Then I'm going to mix the rest of this up, and I'm going to put a little white in there, and a little squirt of alcohol. I'm going to pour some green. I'm just getting rid of all the extra paint that I have left. It's fun to just mess around sometimes. All my paints do have Floetrol in water. Let's see. I do have a little bit of that brushed dark gray. I'll just get rid of that. And there's like a teeny tiny bit, because that was leftover something. I get a lot of good paintings with leftover paint. Put a little squirt in there. Ugh. Every time I use it, I always say, oh, it's leaking, and then that's that. So I am going to take my stick and just go like that through there. I think I'm going to take the black and squirt a little bit more black in than I did last time, because we can't really see it on the vase that I did. Okay, so now I'm going to, you know what, I'm just going to dump them on and see what happens. See what happens. Okay, so I'm going to lift this one. I'm going to drag it around a bit. Ooh, okay, we'll just let that do that. That go where it wants to go. Oh my gosh, those colors look so pretty. Kind of weak. Don't really want it to go anywhere quite yet. I mean, it's moving a touch, but. And I didn't put any other colors on the board because I didn't really know what I planned on doing yet. So now I'm going to lift this up just a little and try to drag it all around through there. Same with the yellow. There's a lot of paint like right in the middle, so I may need to scrape those at the end to get the ends done. So I'm just going to, actually I'm gonna get my heat gun. A little bit here and there. Look at here. Not much. Okay, so now I'm just gonna move it around. See what we get. Kind of slow, because I don't wanna Excuse me. It was too much. I do have some yellow already. Oh, it's on the bottom too. Some yellow already made that I could add a little bit. Now we can see the black too, because the last pour I just put a tiny squirt and it didn't really show. Which it still turned out okay, but. Take my, yeah, a little bit left here in the bottom and just run it on this corner. I don't want to tilt it anymore. There we go. There, I've covered up that corner. Enough to do. But I think, let me get my heat gun out again, see what happens. Alright, I think what I'm going to do is get some yellow. I have some yellow made up from a previous, and I'm going to strip a little bit. There. And maybe, no, I'm gonna leave that right now. But I'm going to get my straw. Color of the mix that I scraped off the bottom. There's always such pretty colors underneath. how that looks though. I'm gonna use my heat gun, see if anything pops up underneath. Yellow go through a little bit more that way. You can really see the shininess from the iridescent medium that I added. All right, I think I'm gonna quit playing around and show you guys. Because from this side it looks a little crazy. And you might think it looks crazy over here. Hopefully you don't and you'll like it. And subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to do that. If you can see how shiny, I mean, besides the glare, always glare, if I can get a little closer, you can see the shininess. And there's little cells popping up still here and there. All right, but there you go. Just a little fun today using leftover paints and see what you can create and come up with some stuff, cool stuff of your own from watching me make something out of leftovers. All right, and thank you for watching.